I recall quickly about QR code. So we just do a quick presentation of ALE. So ALE framework is an open source framework to analyze unstructured data. So unstructured text, unstructured text. So we have different type of text for example, for Tor domains that we crawl, for Telegram. We extract data, we collect them, and then we can analyze them and share it with Mist if we found something interesting. So, a really quick presentation of what happened in ALE. Not all the modules are here, but for example, we extract cryptocurrency, we do some correlation, for example, of favicon, CVUID, a bunch of stuff. But we'll focus mainly on the things that we extract for images, so on the QR code part. So what is interesting for us to extract those QR code? So those QR code has, for example, shared, for example, in a ransomware leak. For example, here it's a leak from a ransom hub, where it's a ransom note. So that's why it's interesting for us to extract them and see what, for example, is in a leak file, what kind of information there is. So quick word on how we extract the QR code. It seems easy when you use our phone, but it's not that easy. In your case, we are using three different libraries. The first one that you try to use for the extraction is PyBar. The advantage of this one is trying to do a bit of rotation to have the QR code in the correct direction. If we don't find anything, we use a QR detector or CV2. In CV2, we have the decode multi. However, this one works if you have multiple QR codes. But sometimes, if you have only one QR code on the images, it doesn't extract it. That's why we are forced to apply the second function to only extract one QR code on images to be sure to extract all of them. However, those two libraries, sometimes they can't really tell you if... they can tell you that there's a QR code on the image, but they can't decode it. That's why we are using another library that's called QR Reader. That's quite resource intensive. It requires a lot of CPU. That's why we only do it on request or when we detect that the other library detects that it's something that looks like a QR code. So I will just show you a quick example of what we found for payment, for anything, Bitcoin, Nickel or cryptocurrency. It's because we can do some correlation. And for example, why you store text in QR code when you can store XML? So yeah, a lot of funky stuff. Some COVID pass for 2 years ago. So this one is cool because it's a size note with a small QR code on the side from the Nemesis market. And some link for an APK from Tor Onion addresses. I didn't put the QR code to be safe, so. So everything is open source. You can find it on ALE project. It's a correct QR code. You can use this one. And thank you.